This is Martin Shervington, and in this video we're going to cover just about everything you need to know about Google Pages, from setting them up all the way through to looking at insights and analytics, as well as the social aspects that will help you connect with your customers and the people that matter to you most. Check out google.com/business and you'll see an overview. You'll find more information on how this is going to help you to be found, the ways you can connect with your customers, how easy it is to manage, as well as an FAQ. Okay, to get started, you'll either need to sign in to your Google account or to set one up. So if I just click on Get on Google here, you'll see I have a couple of accounts, and if it's new, I could add an account. I would then go through the process of either adding that there, or I can create an account and then go through the details. So that's what you'll need to do if you haven't already got an account. If, however, you do have an account, then just click on Sign In, choose the account, add your password, and then click Sign In. If you've signed in, you're able to then see the pages that you manage, which are there, and also just know that you've got the side menu. You can always access it from the Pages tab on the side, and then you get ready to get your page. However, I'm just going to show you something else. If you are already signed into Google and you click Get on Google, you'll be taken straight away to a page that will then ask for your business name and address. So if you're a local type business, then this is where you begin to build your page. If you're not, you click on Not a local business and you'll then be given these options. Now, the reason I mention this is that if I click on Get your page, then you see exactly the same options here. So you've got storefront, service area, and brand. Let's now run through the business types. If it is storefront, then you can see that we've got to give the local address for that, and then we can find the business name. Once you've inputted your address, Google will then send you a postcard to verify that your business is at that location. And if I just go back, the next one is service area. And again, it needs a location for that. And then the final one is a brand. And that's what we're going to set up now. One extra thing here, if you're managing multiple locations, you can click Google My Business Locations, and that will be taken to a dashboard where you can manage them all in one place. Okay, so I'm going to create a page. I've called it Plus Your Business. I have the website and then the type of page. I see the options, and I'm going to go for a brand, and then agree to the page terms. You want to check those out before you agree, and then click Create Page. When you arrive on your new page, you've got the option to go through the tour, and it will just explain step by step what you can add in and all of the information that you need to add. So just to get that process going, it's going to ask to set a profile picture, and I'm just going to grab a logo and I can drag and drop it in, and that then will add. And I can drag out the corners and make sure it's all adjusted. Next, save and continue. Then I want to change the cover photo, so I click on that. Again, I'm going to upload, and I have one that's ready. And I can select an area of that. Then click select cover photo. Save and continue. Next is the contact information. Contact information, and you did decide who you want to have access to that information. But if you're a business, it's likely you're going to want a lot of people to see it. Next, you're going to add in some text for the introduction, and you can add in links as well. And this is a very handy area, so you just hover over and you can add a link then, and then you just click OK when you have. And then let's go save and continue. And the last bit is to add in a tagline. So like that, and go save and continue. Now, once that's done, all we are left to do is then verify that the website that I've added in from the start is then to be linked to this page. you click that, it will come up and it will ask you to basically link it, and you probably need to get in touch with your webmaster to do that. Okay, a little more in the About section. So we're just going to come across the tabs. So the first thing is that to see that you can add in more links. So click on that and you can add custom links, and you can add the name of it and add in a URL so that people can easily access other sites or other content. Also here, you know, you can add in more phone numbers, and you can, you know, always re-edit afterwards. And if you click on edit here, you can decide when people have added you into circles, whether you want other people to know that, and the same with when you've added people into circles. Circles are a bit like your contacts. And when you're ready, you just click save. You'll probably find at some point you'll get offered a custom URL. Now, if you click, it will either allow you to have just the words there, or it will ask you to add a few characters. I agree when you've chosen them, and then change the URL. Okay, next, come across to posts. Now, this is where the social aspect of Google Plus comes into play, and you can click in the box and you can share content. Next to that, you have photos, and you can add photos just by clicking on add photos. And videos, you can click and you can upload new videos, and people can see all of these then on these tabs. And you can have reviews, and these are reviews that you have made. And that's a key difference, because there are some pages, which are the ones that are on the map, where people can leave reviews for you as well. Now, when people do leave reviews on those sorts of pages, when you come up to this tab, you'll actually see a reviews section in here. But because this is the brand page, it's not there. Now, I'm just going to show you how important this is as a local business. I've chosen Oscar's Mexican Seafood, which is my favorite fish taco place in San Diego. And you can see here that I've added the review, and this is a review made as a page. Now, first thing is I can actually share it and let people know. But also, we can come down to create a Google event and meet here with friends. So as soon as that happens, it chooses the location. So Google is very much integrating all of the services through Google Plus. Okay, we've now jumped across to the actual Plus Your Business page, and you can see that there are people in circles, and you can see the content here that's all been filled in. You can also see, if you click on posts, not only can we share content, just put in the same box, but also there's the content that has been shared. Okay, so you see that it says here Google Plus page. If you click that, or you go into that and you click that, this is where you'll end up. So with the content that you've posted. Now, when you start adding people into circles, you can then find that content in your stream. If you click on that icon there. And the stream is content that you can, for instance, plus one, you can comment, and you'll be commenting as the page, so your logo appears, or you could click and you can share that content to an audience. Now, if you just share publicly, it means everyone can see it. But what we'll do is just take a very quick look at circles. So if you come across and you come to people, and this is probably what you see if you are still to add people in, or when you have, you'll see there that there are circles underneath, and you can select groups of people and put them into a circle, so you can categorize people. Okay, coming back to the Google Plus page, and let's look at these icons again. You see the icon there, My Business. Come to this one, you can click and you can get there, and this will give you the dashboard. So the first thing is, if you click in, you'll see that familiar box. And just taking this a little further now, if you click, you can drag and drop and or upload photos from your computer or from your Google Photos, and then select the audience and cancel. Or you could drop in a link, for instance, a blog post, or you can add in a video, and you can even search YouTube or enter a URL or record a video directly right from the camera. And also, you could, if you wanted to, start an event directly from that post as well. And underneath that, you have insights, and you can view insights. And the other way you can view insights is from the menu here. And let's do that. Let's click into the View Insights, and there are three different tabs here, and there's other things that you can click and to see how many views there were on the post, how many profile views there were, in other words, how many people came and saw the page, how many photo views, and then you can click into, as well as change the time, you can change the time on any of these, the engagement, you can see the actions on the posts, and then you can see the actions taken on a particular post and the number of views on a particular post, and you can navigate through on the recent posts, and then the average actions by post type. You hover over and you can see plus ones, comments and shares there. And then you can look at audience. You can see the number of followers. You can hover over and see the date and the number of new followers on a particular date. And you can change and adjust the time scales there. And also you can see the followers by country and the split between male and female. And you can hover over and you can get the exact percentage. Now, just to say that this app on mobile is also fantastic. And whilst we're here, if you click on the cog, you can see you can create a new page and you can view all of the pages that you are a manager of. Okay, so that's the insights. You can also link up your analytics and your YouTube channel, and you'll find the same icon that was here. You can click and visit your YouTube channel directly from there. If you are a local type business, so just jump into one of those sorts of pages, you're also going to see the reviews in the section. You can click on manage reviews, and then for instance you can view and reply directly from within the dashboard and also see analytics. Now, one important thing I'm just going to say is if you come into this, the cog, and you come to settings, you can then look at your connected services. You can look at connection with your site, and you can add managers to a particular page. If you come across to audience, you can then decide if there's anything that you want to restrict in terms of access to that page. Very important with managers, you can have up to 50 people on the page, and that can be a great way of helping with the growth of your Google presence. Just to add that on this sidebar, you'll find your settings there. You can also access all of the pages. So coming back to the dashboard, scrolling down to the last feature here, which is the ability to invite people to a video call. And you can invite people that are in your circles, for instance, and that's a great way of connecting. What I'm also going to show you is that if you come to the sidebar, there's a few other things. You can click to find communities to which you relate. Also, you can set up your own community. You can start events. And if you click this one, these are both the video calls that I just mentioned, but also a Hangout on Air that integrates and can be streamed live on YouTube or as a private event. So there's a lot you can do from within the Google Plus page. A couple of other things. If you go to this bar, you can search for people or pages or posts, or just put keywords in and have an explore there. And if you come across to the bell, you'll have your Google Plus notifications. And when, for instance, somebody adds you into a circle, you'll be able to find out who they are and you can potentially add them back. So this is a great way of connecting you with customers or potential customers. This is Martin Shervington, and I hope that was a useful tour of your Google Plus page. I'm sure you've got questions, so we've put together a quick starter guide. If you just click the annotation and sign up, you'll have access to a series of free videos and PDFs that will cover just about everything you'll need to know to get you flying on Google Plus. So click the annotation and we'll see you at plusyourbusiness.com and in the Plus Your Business community. Many thanks.